Unlike a lot of the people I know who work here at NASA, I actually was not space crazy as a child. When I was in ninth grade, my high school physics teacher offered extra credit to anyone that entered a contest. And the idea was to propose an experiment that could be done on the way to Mars, on a human mission to Mars. So I wrote the paper and ended up being selected as a regional winner in the competition and got to go to Kennedy Space Center in Florida. And I got to present that paper to some real-life NASA engineers, which was really exciting for me as a 15-year-old high school freshman. And that's kind of what sparked my interest in spaceflight and in potentially working for NASA someday in the future. My name is Sarah Ruiz, and I work in the Safety and Mission Assurance Directorate at Johnson Space Center as an Operations and Visiting Vehicle Safety Engineer for the International Space Station Program. When I talk to students, especially younger students, without exception, they think that NASA is just really, really cool. And I think as people grow up, sometimes they kind of start to lose that along the way. And I think that's a shame. There is really room here for all types of people. You've got everyone from engineers to businessmen to accountants and lawyers, media people, creative people, artists, musicians. I mean, really all types of people. As a high school senior, I started doing as much research as I could into how to become a co-op once I went to college. Being a co-op is like being an intern, except you go back to the same work location over and over. There's a couple big advantages to the co-op program. The biggest is probably that you get that real-world work experience. It's getting outside the classroom and understanding what having a job and working as an engineer in the field is really like. One of the other big benefits is that it's paid, and so the money that you earn while you are co-oping can help with your expenses while you're working. It can also help you pay for school. One of my most exciting days in my NASA career so far was probably the first space shuttle launch that I worked from the Mission Control Center. It was just for launch, so it was just for those 8.5 minutes from the time the engines lit to the time it hit main engine cutoff. I had been in training for the position for probably almost 2 years by that point, and I knew what needed to be done. I was very confident that I could do the job well, but being there sitting on console and knowing that for the first time everything that I was seeing was happening for real was simultaneously kind of terrifying and also super exciting. Being a woman who chose to become an engineer was never strange. That wasn't weird, that wasn't unusual. I don't necessarily notice if I'm the only girl in the room because I'm doing what I want to be doing. I do think a lot of girls sometimes think that's strange, or they're intimidated by the thought of math and science or engineering. I think girls are just as capable of being in technical fields as men, and they should pursue what they're interested in. I just recently finished a master's degree in digital media studies from a local university. I'm an engineer, but I try and balance that technical side with a more creative side. I think it's really important to engage both sides of your brain. I think that makes you a better, more whole person overall and a better contributor. NASA is still, just as we were in the past, we are still doing really, really amazing things every day. And I want to keep trying to help people realize that.